Hello, and welcome to Deep End Theater. I'm Lloyd Kolar, and now I'll be your host as we journey through this series of stimulating and intellectually challenging video vignettes. Our first number is a cute little ditty called Where's Daryl?
Did you hear something?
I didn't hear anything.
I know.
I heard something. I really heard something.
I didn't hear anything.
But I thought I heard something.
Oh, well.
What was that? What was that? I know I heard something. Did you hear it?
I didn't hear anything. Please go back to work and leave me alone.
But I know I heard it.
But I didn't.
But I know I just don't go around hearing things.
Evidently you do.
Did you hear that? I know I heard that.
I heard it too.
And leave it there!
What kind of YouTube thing is that?
Alas, poor Daryl. I knew him, Horatio. Well, our next number involves a young chap who is having a little difficulty coping with life's many frustrations. It's called temporary insanity.
Drill, are you out of your mind?
What possessed you to do a dumb thing like that?
But Joel, man, I don't know, because, you know, you're going to be missing a lot, man. I don't know.
Is our passport to the future. For tomorrow belongs to those people who prepare for it today. These words spoken by Malcolm X are just as true today as when he quoted them many years ago. And passport is the perfect metaphor for education. I've even got a few of my own. Take this library for instance. I consider this to be my personal sweet shop. Here you can have your cake, huh? And read it too. So stake your claim in the future. Pull up to the buffet of knowledge. Dig in and have yourself a heaping helping. Read.
Damn. See it.
You had it come. Well, I think he's dead.
He ain't dead, he just got his brains knocked out.
Kick him a few times. Still not moving. Think we're getting trouble for this?
Nah. Yeah. Alright, I'm good looking. I can't help it, so sue me.
I wanna rock right now. I'm my bass and I came to get down. I'm not internationally known, but I'm known to rock the microphone because I get stupid. I mean outrageous. Stay away from me, you're contagious. Cause I'm the winner, no, not a loser. To be an MC is what I choose. A ladies love me, girls adore me. I mean, even the ones who never saw me like the way that I rhyme at a show. The reason why I'm mad, I don't know. So let's go, cause it takes me to the next thing you do now. like it, so what? I don't care. I'm number one, so uno, I like mom. Bring all the fuckers, cause all of them I'll find. Don't want to drink, but I won't protest. All of my followers, cause all I want is respect. I'm not a boxer, but the man rocker. Flick brother that can leave the outfoxer. Cause I'm raw, the last name basic. And over my mic, I'm known to be the freshest. So let's start, it can be too hard. I'm not a sucker, so I don't need a bodyguard. I won't flex where bulletproof vest. Don't smoke Buddha, can't stand sex, yes.
Hey, she's gonna make a thing over. You think she's gonna make it out of the high? You think she's gonna make a thing over? You think she's gonna make it out of the high?
The situation, I got the base game. I'm kinda silly, that's why I don't wanna win. A funky rhyme to a fall or a good friend. Now listen up, cause I want you to comprehend. Cause I'm a leader, the man, superior. I take curia, then you get weary. Cause that's it, my mother not counterfeit. The record sells, this makes this wanna hit. It won't hurt, to listen to red alert. Take off the shirt, and so it don't hit the dirt. I like the kids, the guys, the girls. I want the judges with the broad-based world. I'm on a mission, you better just listen. To my rhymes, cause I'm all about just the cause.
Hey, she's gonna make things go right. You think she's gonna make it out of the house? You think she's gonna make things go right? You think she's gonna make it out of the house?
I stand alone, don't need anyone. Cause I'm raw, just came to have fun. Don't need friends that act like folks. Cause I'm raw, face the one who knows about things. That makes you get weary. Don't hear me, just hear me out. Cause I got the clout, shout. Before I turn the party out, I won't shut up, project my voice pretty clearly. So you can be my choice on stage. All wrecked, go through the wind and select it. Take it off the rack and the back to the back. I like the Whopper, the Big Mac. You want static, so let's go, go. Throw up your hands, go for what you know. Bro, I got an ego. Yo, talking to me? No. Oh, plug robbers in the front, easy rockers on the back up. We're not soft, so you better just slap up. Cause I'm cool, so I'm just like the breeze. Rock the mic with the help of easy rock. On the set, the music plays. Only cut the record that I play.
You think she's gonna make things go right? You think she's gonna make it out of sight? You think she's gonna make things go right? You think she's gonna make it out of sight?
All right, now, easy rock now. When I count to three, I want you to get busy. You ready now? One, two, three, get loose now.
Greg, you did good, and I felt embarrassed, but I felt good about myself because.
Our last number is the retelling of a traditional African folktale. It centers around a particular rodent having problems with its living quarters. It's marvelously directed with some riveting acting and meticulous lighting scheme, which is bound to transcend the audience to a time and dimension.
Will you please get on with it?
Right. As we're told by Verna Ardima and narrated by Angela Seegers, Who's in Rabbit's House?
Es una gloria. De mañana es una historia de amor. Es una historia que amor genera por nuestro mundo. Es una historia de mi corazón. There's a song to make you sad. There has a song to sing. It never seems as bad. To me came this melody. So I've tried to put in words how I feel. Tomorrow will be for you and me. Yeah, I'm singing. I'm singing.
Ago, Rabbit lived on a bluff overlooking a lake. A path went by his door and down the lake to the water. The animals of the forest used that path when they went to the lake to drink. Every day at dusk, Rabbit sat in his doorway and watched them. But one evening, he came to his house and could not get in. And a big, bad voice from inside the house roared,
I am the wrong one. I eat trees and trample on elephants. Go, I'll trample on you.
That's my house. Come out at once.
But the bad animal said more cross than before.
Go away, or I'll trample on you.
And the rabbit sat down on a nearby log to think. Now Frog happened to see this. He hopped up to the rabbit and said rather timidly,
I think I can get it out.
Sniffed the rabbit.
You think you can do it? I cannot. You are so small. You annoy me. Go away.
Frog would have left that rude rabbit for Jackal not, had not came along just then. Instead, he crouched behind a nearby tree to see what would happen. The Jackal said,
Ho, rabbit. Why don't you sit in your doorway?
Someone's in my house. I can't get in, and he won't come out.
Jackal looked at the little house.
Who's in Rabbit's house?
The bad voice from inside replied,
I am the wrong one. I eat trees and trample on elephants. Go, or I'll trample on you.
I'm going.
Off he ran.
Jackal, come back. Please help me.
Jackal came back.
I think I know what to do. We must gather a big pile of sticks.
They did.
Thank you.
Now we must put them close to the house, like this.
But Jackal, that will keep them in, not get them out.
I'm going to set fire to the house.
Fire!
Fire, fire, fire.
Stop. That will burn my house.
It will burn the long one too.
I'm going to let you burn my house. Go away.
So the Jackal trotted off to the lake. A leopard came by.
What are you doing, Rabbit? Are you putting sticks there to hide your house?
No, not that. Someone's in my house. Jackal wanted to burn them out, so now I have to remove these sticks from my house.
Leopard watched as Rabbit removed the sticks. Then he asked,
"Who's in Rabbit's house?"
The bad voice said,
"I am the long one. I eat trees and trample on elephants. Go away, I will trample on you."
"You don't scare me. I'm tough. I'll tear this house into bits and eat you up."
And he leaped on top of the little house and began to scratch, scratch, scratch. Bits of roof went flying.
"Stop!"
cried Rabbit.
"I won't let you spoil my house."
"What good is a house with a bad animal in it?"
"But it's still my house. Go away."
So the leopard jumped down and went to the lake. The frog grinned and chuckled to himself. Rabbit climbed onto his roof. He smoothed and patted it. An elephant came by.
"I'm ready to get out of this thing."
"What happened, Rabbit? Does your roof leak?"
"No, not that. Someone's in my house. Leopard wanted to tear him up and eat him to bits, so now I have to smooth my roof."
"Who's in Rabbit's house?"
"I am the long one. I eat trees and trample on elephants. Go away, I will trample on you."
"Trample on elephants? Who thinks he can trample on elephants? I'll trample you flat, flat as a mat. I'll trample you house and all."
Elephant charged toward the house. Rabbit leaped in front of him.
"Stop! Don't smash my house."
"I'm only trying to help."
"I don't want that kind of help. Go away."
So the elephant jumped off to the lake, and the frog laughed aloud.
"Stop laughing, frog. See what that stupid elephant did to my yard? He made holes in it, so now I have to smooth my yard."
He found his hoe and set to work. A rhinoceros came by.
"What are you doing, Rabbit? Are you putting a farm here by your house?"
"No, not that. Someone's in my house. Elephant wanted to trample him. He made holes in my yard, so now I had to smooth it."
"Who's in Rabbit's house?"
"I am the long one. I eat trees and trample on elephants. Go away, I'll trample on you."
"Fool! I'll hook you on my horn and rush into the lake, house and all."
He put his head down and went toward the house. But the rabbit leaped onto his nose. He held the nose with his little paws. Rhinoceros tossed his head up and away when Rabbit went over the lake. The rhinoceros shook himself in a satisfied way.
"That's the end of the long one."
"But Rhino, that was Rabbit you threw into the lake."
Rhinoceros looked. The little house was not gone, but Rabbit was. The two rushed down the bluff to save Rabbit. When Rabbit hit the water, he went blah, blah, blah. He kicked his way to the surface. Elephant was still drinking at the lake. He saw the rabbit come up.
"Keep kicking."
Elephant swam out and put his trunk around Rabbit and carried him to shore.
Yay! "Say, but I don't know why. Nothing but a pop."
"Thank you, Elephant."
Mm-mm.
poor rabbit. He went up the hill to his house, but he still could not get in. He sat on a log and began to cry. The fox came up from the lake.
Don't cry, rabbit. I think I can get the bad animal out of your house, if you let me try.
How?
Scare him out.
But how?
Watch me.
I know.
He took a leaf and curled it around to make a horn. When he talked into it, it made his voice very loud. He said through the horn,
"Who's at Robin's house?"
Let's go.
Go.
I am the wrong one. I eat trees and trample on elephants. Go away or I will trample on you.
I am the spinning cobra. I can blind you with my poison. Now come out or I will squeeze under the door and spit poison into your eyes.
Then the door opened. Out came a long, colorful caterpillar. He was so scared his legs were jumping. He was looking everywhere.
Great spinning cobra, don't let the spinning cobra get me. I was only playing a joke.
It's only a caterpillar,
cried Rabbit.
Only a caterpillar,
echoed Frog. He called the other animals. They laughed when they saw that the bad animal was only a caterpillar. But the long one did not laugh. He was still saying,
"Where's the spinning cobra? Where's the spinning cobra?"
The rabbit said,
"Oh, long one, the spinning cobra was only Frog."
Frog laughed so hard, all you could see was his big laugh. Then the big animals went away. The log one crawled up a tree. Rabbit sat in his doorway, and the frog sat on the log, croaking with laughter. The end.
I'm glad to see things finally worked out for Rabbit. Do you think the long one really learned his lesson of pulling pranks? Well, that's all we have time for in this section of Deep End Theater. Thank you for allowing us into your home. Be careful and have a good summer. ¶¶